here's what I want to say to you about this. You can maybe wear new underwear, but when it gets down to washing it, it always falls apart, doesn't it? You know what I mean? It just, being in the movies is wonderful. I love being a Latin star. It's, something I've dreamt of since I was a little Latin girl in Brooklyn. And now, here I am in Mexico, eating at the Puerto Roja. It's Terry's place, and everybody who's anybody is here. And, of course, you know, Maria Felix ate here, and, Lola Montez ate here, and Katie Dorado ate here, and now I'm here. Joan Alamos is a good name, isn't it? I know you like it, but listen, you can be a Latin star. All you have to have is the sexy stuff, you know what I mean? You have to turn on the sexy stuff. When you're a famous movie star, everybody comes and they look at your pictures and then they use the same lipstick. So I have lipstick, I have it all the time, you know, I get it out of my pockets full of it. Sometimes I sit on it, I get a big squashy feeling. You know, what can I tell you? It's a big stain, you know. People think you're bleeding to death, but you're not. It's just you just have a little lipstick squash in you, you know. Lots of mascara. You have to put it on your eyes. And then you have to be careful because you put on too much sometimes and you look, you know, you look crazy, but nobody really cares about that much, you know, really, when you get down to it. Because wearing your mascara and wearing, what I'm talking about, the perfume, you have to wear the perfume to do this, you have to wear it. I want to say goodbye to you and all of my fans out there. I'll be in my next movie, you'll see it on YouTube. I'll be there drinking the vino claro famous of Alamos. Me, Joan Alamos, right here in Alamos, saying goodbye to you and lots of kisses from me to you. Well, I've been looking forward to talking to you about several things that have been going through my mind, and I kind of put them away because, well, I just didn't feel like talking about them, you know, they kind of come and they go, and then I sometimes think ready to about them, and then sometimes I go, and I just stop talking, you just don't want to talk, and that's the long and short of it. After all, I'm a very high-strung movie star, and besides that, my mother is scheduled to meet me here, and I'm really not looking forward to that because, to tell you the truth, she looks a little younger than me. I think that she's taking some kind of goat hormones, you know. I don't know what's happening there, but she seems to be getting a little younger every day, and I'm getting circles around my mascara, if you know what I mean. And anyway, I'm here at Puerto Roja, eating the fabulous chicken salad. That's salada de pollo. That's how you say it in Spanish, you know, or Mexican, as some of the people say around here. They don't know it's Spanish anyway, but let me tell you, there are not enough people who speak Spanish here. And we sometimes wonder whether it's worthwhile being a Mexican Estrella. Oh my good. Now, here's my mother. What did I tell you about how young she looks? She must be getting goat injections or hormones or something. I'm just getting circles around my mascara. Oh, but I love seeing her, though. She's really spectacular, isn't she? She's Norma. She's oh, my goodness. You know, she married Anthony Quinn, you know, one of his several wives here in Mexico. Nobody ever talked about that, but I am the issue, as they say. After all, I am a star, a Mexican movie star. Joan Alamos, you know, and I expect not to pay for my drinks and my food. You know, people like to see me on the screen, and they love saying hello, you know, on the streets, but kind of depressed today because I am still waiting to get a call from my agent in Mexico City saying he has a new epic, lined up for me. Since Maria Felix and Katie Gennaro have gone to the place in the heavens, right? And I gave them a little help getting there too, you know. It's about time for me to get those big starring roles with Ramon Amaro and Robert Mitchum, you know. I have, the white teeth. See the white teeth? The white teeth. All the Mexican stars, estrellas, have white teeth. Well, they have their white teeth. They have to have them, or you can't be a Mexican star. And you have to also be a little sexy, too, you know. You have to drink. Vino Claro. You have to drink it all the time and be bubbly for the public. And then even though you want to jump, in the garbage can, you have to be the bubbly Mexican star. Anyway, I don't really know if that's a backhanded compliment or not, saying that I look so dramatic with all my mascara and my white teeth. Being a little crazy drinking the Claro, I got the crazy hair too. But I didn't have it combed today, so I just put mine through it, and I had the dog run through that. I kind of laid on the floor. I called him, Pero, Pero, Pero. And the dog, he just came over and he just kind of jumped on me and he ran through my hair, So, anyway, that's what it takes to be a big Mexican star. You have to have the pedal run for your hair, the dog, the little doggy, the little chihuahua, And then you got to keep your teeth very white and use a lot of, that you put that on your eyes. You put the Maybelline, Maybelline and the mascara. It is the best, You could put it on like charcoal on a fire, It will light your eyes. And then you go out into the public and you say hello to the peoples and then they all wave back to you and sometimes they ask for your autograph and you just say, well, I will give it to you but only for money, You keep them like that, then they beat you up in the streets and then they throw you in the garbage. The Mexican people, they want their movie stars to be for free, So that's why I'm waiting for the agent to call me because then I could be some money, I wouldn't have to ask my family, but if you have some, yes, I know you give it to me, but if you have some money, I know you do want to give it, then you just give it to me, Joan Alamo.
Well, I love the French fries. I used to eat them in Paris when I was in there, and I like them a lot. You can't call them French fries in Paris. They think you're crazy, So you just call them the pommes frites, They bring the pommes frites, and you put the salt on them when you eat them, It was me and Maria Felix. We used to go there all the time and eat all the pommes frites in the cafe and wave at all the gentlemen who would come by and try to pay us the attentions, They would just try to pay us the attentions, but we were so famosa, we didn't care about the Frenchmen. Who cares about the Frenchmen anyway? They're just a bunch of Frenchmen. They don't have the Mexican, what I'm talking about, romantico, they're always talking through their nose, the Frenchmen. So we would sit at the cafe and we would just talk, and Marie used to think I was crazy to take the name Joan Alamo. She goes, I left the Alamos when I was about 10 years old. I will never go back. That's a burg, But what are you doing there anyway? What do you have your name like? I said, well, I didn't know that, but I was in Brooklyn growing up. I used to see your picture in the movies, And I thought, well, let me call myself Joan Alamo, Movie star famosa, because that is where Maria Felix, started, but I didn't know that you left the place, that it was a burg. I don't know what I'm going to do now. I can't change my name. I'm already famoso, Everybody recognizes me here when I come out. All of your boys come by, Oh, look at this Joan Alamo, She's sitting eating the French fries, They call them the Papas Franciscans here, They don't call them the pommes frites, but I eat them and I wave to the boys. The boys, well, I remember me from the movies with Ramon Amaro and the one with a Burt Lancaster, when he's swinging from the ceiling and things like that. He was a Burt. He had the bone, too, like Ramon, They put the wood back in Hollywood. That's what I'm telling you right here, but he says so, too. But anyway, I wish you all could come down to see my next movie. You'll see it on the YouTube. I'll be there starring with someone famous, so don't know who it is going to be, and I'm waiting for my agent and Al Capulco to call me, tell me who it's going to be. I don't mind that really working with dead actors. You know, you put them in a corner and you feed them some lies. Somebody move their lips. It doesn't make no difference. You know, I am the estrella. You know, I'm the star, so what I say is really the most important thing, you know? Anyway, oh, I love these french fries, you know, they're so salty, you know what I mean? You can order a little, I love your french fries. Anyway, I hope you come to see me in my next movie. I have a new mascara and a new lipstick I'm gonna wear for you, and I hope that you like them. It's gonna be in Technicolor, you know? I like to be filmed in a black and white because I look so dramatic, you know? Don't look like anybody else in the world, only me. Joan Alamos, a movie star famosa. So I'll be thinking of you, and I hope you come to see me again in my movies, and you'll see me acting out a storm, you know what I mean? It would be a real storm, so anyway, hasta luego, amigos. Yes, hasta luego. Me, Joan Alamos, a movie star famosa, and I'm here at the Casa de las Lunas, which means the House of the Moons. You can't believe what's going on here. This house is just filled, you know, there's me, the movie star famosa, you know, and there's also the Whitey Vanilla, who's absolutely
the
crazy,
party.
And then you got the Justin and the Joan, you know, they're over there in Technicolor, while me and Whitey are in black and white. You can't believe it, how bad it is only to be in black and white, you know. So I'm trying to see what I'm going to do in this house, you know. And Whitey, he's always crawling in my bed in the middle of the night, and he wants to be in the movies with me. He keeps talking to me, he goes, Joan Alamos, I want to be in the movies, you know, but you can't put him in the movies. He's just a crazy person, you know. Nobody would want to be in the movies with him. Who is going to pay any money to see him? Me, they would see Joan Alamos. I got the sexy hair and the sexy teeth, and I got lots of mascara, you know. But anyway, I wish you all are going to have a Merry Christmas, you know, and you, everybody is having lots of fun, you know. Thinking of me, Joan Alamos, movie star famosa. My next movie will be out soon. You'll see me. You know, I'll be having the mascara, the crazy mascara. You know, like I can start a forest fire. So much.
Well, here I am at the Granny Cafe, where we have the most famous mayonnaise sandwiches. We love to eat them, and we have the waiters here too, who we really adore. There's Esteban and Dennis and Angel. Angel in English, and we love to watch them dance and to sing. And every day I try to get down to the park just to see them. And when I do, my whole life lights up. It's just like paradise. I love being a Mexican movie star, famosa. It's the best thing that ever happened to me.